Hallo everyone, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Soo dhawaada casharkeena maalmaha. Soo marka casharkeena tanba waxaan idin sheegaynaa inaan online tutoring sameyno, waxaan ku sameynaa via Zoom. Qofki xiiseynayo marka Zoom meeting ID geena waxa waaye 473-079-3330. Passcode ku waaye CK1UN5. Qof walbo rabo inaan online wax ku barno meeshaasu nagala soo xiriiri karaa haddii uu ilaahay raaco. Soo casharkeena marka buuggeena magaciisu waa Essential English 1. maantana waxaan marownaa casharka lesson 18 casharka 18-aad 18th lesson. Soo casharka maanta wuxuu ku saabsan yahay the future tense, yani falka oo maarkino mustaqbalka maarkino. In the sentence, jumlooyinkan, you will hear about Mistress Brisley. Marka wilkan will hear waxaa mustaqbalka maqlaysa, waxaa maqli doontaa wax ku saabsan Mr. Brisley. She will tell you, waxay idin sheegi doontaa about her house, waxa ku saabsan gurigooda. She will tell you, yani waxa mustaqbalka dhacay waay. I will gladly tell you about it, waxaan ku faraxsanahay, si farxad leh idinku jeclaa inaan idinku sheego wax ku saabsan gurigeyga. You will hear more about it in book 2, waxaana waxa wax badan ka maqlaysaan buugga labaad markii la gaaro. So marka waxaan baranoonaa tenska oo mustaqbalka future tense si loo sameeyo. You have examples of the future tense, waxaa haysataa tusaalooyinka future tenseiga. Here are some more examples, yani halkan waa kuwa tusaalooyin kaloo badan. Richard Brown will be 14 years old tomorrow, marka beri oo marka 14 jir naqaana. He will be up early tomorrow morning, subaxda beri subaxii oo ciyo soo jeedaa. His father will give him a new bicycle for his birthday, aabihiis wuxuu siin doonaa biskuleet cusub oo dhalashadiisa. His sister Mary said to him, waxay ku dhahday, you will be 14 tomorrow, I shall be 10 next June, anigana waxaan noqon doonaa 10 jir June soo socoto. To make the future tense, loo sameeyo falka oo future-ka, we use will with the infinitive of the verb. Verb-ka caadigiisa iyo will aan ka hormareynaa. You will hear of the infinitive verb about Mr. Brisley. She will laga hormari tell oo ah infinitive, you about the house. Richard will be infinitive, be daneti waxa waa verb to be ga u taagantaa will be. So infinitive verb-ka oo will laga hormariyay la waaye marka la sameynayo future tenses-ka. But with the first person, I and we sometimes use shall ama marka qaarkood isticmaalnaa, and sometimes will. This is not a full explanation, it is only a small part of the subject. The future tense is explained more fully in Essential buugga labaad aad loogu sharxi doonaa iguna. Marka waxaan basic aadana la barobaa lesson 18. In conversation, will and shall are often shortened to, waxaa loo soo gaabiyaa laba la. You will hear about Mr. Brisley's house, he will be up early tomorrow morning, Richard will be 14 tomorrow, I will be 10 next June. Marka apostrophe L marka la isticmaalo will iyo shall also gaabi waay. The negative of the future tense is formed by adding not la lagu daraa sida present ga sameyn jirna camal. Will not, shall not, that's it, not la lagu daba daraa. Mr. Brisley will not tell you about her house, Richard will not be 14 until tomorrow, his father will not give him a bicycle, I shall not be 10 until June. Will not is generally shortened in the conversation as won't, sana loso gabi amarki laga hadla I won't. Will not also gabi lewa. She won't tell you about her house, Richard won't be 14 until tomorrow, his father won't give him a bicycle, he will not, negative qua, he will not. And Suasha, the interrogative of the future tense is formed by putting the verb will or shall before subject galago hormare now. Will Mr. Brisley, will you, will Richard, shall I, Mr. Brisley, you say the students want to hear about my house. Shall I tell them about it now? Haddamu sheegi karaa. So marka verbka aa laga shall kale laga soo hormarinaa. I shall tell you meesha aad. Shall I tell you. We do not often use will I or will we. Usually shall I or shall we aan isticmaalnaa. He will. Making interrogative. Sometimes we express future meaning by using the present continuous. Often with a word or phrase like tomorrow, next week, etc. That gives the future meaning. Okay, I'm going to London tomorrow. Any present continuous that's imagine tomorrow, just it's going to be future. Henry is playing football on Tuesday. Mary is coming here next week. Imane, sa future. We are going to Paris next year. Something that may happen. Marka present continuous the next year you has lugudaro. Ano gane future? Where is that? Many words in English are both nouns and verbs. Here are some in lesson 1 to 18 with examples to show their use. Oh, okay. So I can answer the question. Give the answer to the question. So the word answer marno waxaa loo isticmaalaa noun marna verb. Number marno waxaa loo isticmaalaa verb marna noun. Please number tiri waaye. The picture is in the book. Put a number dig under the picture. Marka la dhaho noun ee naqane. Hammer the nails verb way. Garaac way. Bruise and nails in the wall. Derbiga in the well. In well. Nails in well. Use the big hammer. Isticmaal marka hammerka for those nails. Hammerka marka noun way. Marna waxa way waxa la sameynay. And nail marwaa waa loo isticmaal waa verb marna noun. Nail the pictures on the wall. Use small nails to do it. Name, can you name all things in the picture? What's your name? Stay, the people are staying at the Devon Hotel. We are not making a long stay here. We drink tea from teacups. I'm going to have a drink with George. Smoke. Some of the men are smoking cigarettes. Look at the smoke from the engine. Sleep. The dog is sleeping under the table. The dog is having a sleep under the table. And shade. The compass shades the people from the sun. The compass gives shade from the sun. And dress. The lady dresses very well. She is wearing a white dress. Swim. One of the boys is swimming to the rock. Come and have a swim in the sea. Cook. Lizzie cooks the meals. She is a good cook. Bath. We bath at the seaside. He goes for a bath in the sea. Bath. And the mother bathes her baby every day. You can see the baby's bath in the picture. Walk. One of the girls is walking to the sea. Come for a walk in the fields. Climb. The man is climbing the mountain. It is difficult to climb. It is a difficult climb to the top of the mountain. Step. You can step out the motor car now. The boy is walking down the steps. Work. The man works in the field. This work is bad. So marwa ogaane verbki noun as a verb aa loo isticmaalaa. Essential English book-gaana magacis waaye, you can use all these words now. Can you understand the use of these words now? Related words. Kalmadaasi wax xiriiraan waaye. Pleasant. I'm pleased to be here. This is a very pleasant work. Manly. He is not a man yet, but he speaks in a manly way. Proud, pride. Mr. Breeze is proud of his son. He looks at him with pride. Gaiety. Waa farxadeed waa tan. Mr. is guy unhappy. Mr. Priestley loves her guide. Gold, golden. My watch is made of gold. It is a gold watch. Her hair is golden, like a golden cone. Dinner, dining room. We dine at 7 o'clock. We have dinner then in the dining room. Everyone, everybody. Everything, everywhere, every day. Good morning, everybody. Everyone, everything in the house is clean and good. He never goes by train. He goes everywhere by airplane. These phrases are used in everyday conversation. Lesson 18 guli waa socdaa. Nobody, no one, nothing, nowhere, none. There is nobody, no one here. He does nothing all day long except eat and sleep. They want a house. They have nowhere to live. None of the students will be in the class tomorrow. Somebody, someone, something, somewhere. Somebody is coming to see the house today. She will tell us something about her work. They can come to our house. They will be somewhere for there to live. Anybody, anyone, anything, anywhere. Is anybody coming to see the house today? She will not tell us anything about the work. These people have not anywhere to live. Note, we generally use something, somewhere, etc. In affirmative sentence, we use anything, anywhere in interrogative and negative sentence. So in affirmative, interrogative, negative, how can jumla caadi su'aal diidmo. She wants some new dresses. Does she want any? So marka interrogative tahay any aa la isticmaala. No, some aa la isticmaala. Any new dress? She does not want any new dress. There are some books on the table. Are there any books on the table? There are not any books on the table. He sees somebody in the room. Does he see anybody in the room? He does not see anybody in the room. He sees somebody in the room. There is something interesting in the newspaper today. Is there anything interesting in the newspaper? There isn't anything interesting in the newspaper today. He's going somewhere today. Is he going anywhere today? He's not going anywhere today. Essential English book is why kind. Notice the two meanings of kind. Labada macno ee leedahay kind. She's kind and gentle. Margaret is not fond of study of any kind. What kind of dress is she wearing? Greetings, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. So exercise kala so gare arda adin kala den karaba. So write in this sentence, putting the verb in brackets into the future sense. So I to write waxaan in I future ka dhigtida laga raba ardayga laga raba. So su'aalaha waa kuwana akhrista ka shaqeeya. Make this sentence interrogative and negative. Diidmo iyo su'aalaha ka dhigee. Marka he will tell us about his work. Interrogative se looga dhigaa. Diidmana se looga dhigaa ardada laga raba. Make sentence using these words as a noun or verb. Smoke noun isticmaal marna verb isticmaal. Work all these words. Toban iyo labadan it ardada laga raba in isticmaala. Use each in the sentence. Jumla kuna question maashida laga raba question ka afraad. Everyone su'aal jumla gili illa iyo dining room. Toban iyo todobaas ardada laga raba. Question kishnaad waxa dhahay make this sentence interrogative su'aal mark no di su'aal ka dhig. He wants some eggs. Then su'aal ka dhig. So 10 keena maanta waa naga intaas. Assalaamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.